If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe. Hello everyone, Melcadrien here, and I'm here to show you Yankai's Triangle. Yankai's Triangle? Yankai's Triangle? However it's pronounced. Anyways, this is actually a post-commentary. When I recorded this and I finished up, the commentary somehow got erased. I don't know how, it just did. So this is all post-commentary. Now before I talk about the game, I'd like to thank the developer for providing a digital key of this game for me. Thank you. So what is Yankai's Triangle? Well, Yankai's Triangle is a puzzle game with a lot of triangles. A lot of triangles. And only that, but... Well, there are two variations you can play this game with. There is the colorblind mode, which is the shape mode, and there is the color mode, which basically shows the colors. Now, one thing I like to point out, some point in this video you'll notice that some of the square shapes, they don't seem to connect whenever I shift the triangle to connect to that point. I don't know why, I don't know how, it just does not work. It might just be that it is actually a different color altogether. I'm associating this with the with colors, mainly because each level has three colors, mainly. Now, for the shapes, I seem to have noticed that there are only two shapes. Is that a bug, or did the developers forget to associate the third shape with a different shape altogether? I don't know. I just don't know. But what I do know is that it is a bit of a bug, so if you're playing it with the shape mode or colorblind mode, you're gonna have to do some brute forcing until they patch that. If they patch that. Man, I sure hope they do patch it, because that can be infuriating to some people. Anyways, what I found very interesting is that the triangles themselves didn't keep me a whole lot interested, because it's basically just putting the colors together and whatnot. It's the puzzles. It's also the atmosphere. Later on in this video, you'll notice that some of the triangles have some quirks. Some real interesting quirks. Which really made me think, wow. That is one way to keep a person interested. I mean, think about it. The triangle has eyes. And it makes a more fleshy sound instead of a rock sound, an earthy sound. So yeah, it just makes me go, wow, that is interesting. And that might keep people interested in this game. For me, it really actually caught my interest, you know, when I was just, you know, playing through this for you guys. When I reached that point, it was like, holy crap. It just like threw me through a loop. Yes, it was only for that one level only. It may appear again from time to time, I don't know. But it just really threw me through a loop. So, yeah, it really is pretty amazing. Pretty amazing that something like this happened. So, there really isn't a whole lot for me to talk about this game. Oh, except for what is actually on the top. As you can see, there are a number of numbers. The first one on the top left is the number of connections. The number of connections. If you disconnect it and reconnect it, it adds one to that score. The second one is the number of turns you've made, which is basically turning the triangle. And the third one is basically the total time and the time you've spent in that level. So what do I think about this game? Well, it certainly is interesting. I mean, the game basically gives you an Inception feel. Or let me relate it to a different game. It basically has you go in and out of these triangles to make sure that you've gotten things connected. It reminds me quite a bit of Circa Infinity. Yes, I want to name drop that game here because it reminds me a bit of that. It's not the actual mechanics of it, but the idea of, you know, moving into something and then moving out of it. It's the one thing that really interested me. Now, whether that would actually interest you or not is up to you. But the price itself, it's pretty much manageable. It's less than $5. If that interests you, I'd say give this a try. If you're very wary of this game, but you still want to try it, well, maybe it'll go on sale in the future. How far in the future, I do not know. But for less than $5, there really isn't going to be a whole lot of a bargain when it does go on sale. Unless it goes on a really bargain bin price. But I don't see this game going into a bargain bin price at this time. I think that this would be... It's gonna be an interesting game for people who might be enthusiastically interested in it. I mean, it made me interested in it, but I can't exactly invest a whole lot of time into it because I've got a lot of other stuff to take care of. I've got a lot of other games to play. And besides, this is an impressions video, and I generally just want to show the game off to you guys. That's what an impressions is. If I want to do a full playthrough, then I usually buy the game myself. Anyways, I hope this has interested you in buying the game or not. If not, that's fine. I hope this video has entertained you. If not, well, at least you have less time to waste. I mean, you're probably watching this video to see if you're interested in this. If you're not, well, if you're not entertained, then you're basically just give yourself less of a day to worry about. You know, you have less free time, or less time to waste, basically. Anyways, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below, and follow me on Twitter and or Tumblr if you want to. I do, however, appreciate it a lot. Thank you. I also would like to thank the developers once again for providing a digital key of this game for me. Thank you. Now, I am Melcadrien, and this has been Yankai's Triangle. Yankai's... Anyways, I am Melcadrien, and I'll see you all next time. Have a wonderful day, and happy gaming.